while we were coming back, I noticed that there was a church here. So I asked him, which people worship here? He said, it's Deeper Life. I said, okay, no problem. Now maybe next Sunday, I will come here and worship. So that Sunday, it happened that I came in, and the message that they were from pastor was, beat down my vision. I remember going by what I wrote down in my chapter. And it was a very striking message to me. And aside that, the welcome was very, very warming. And I was really touched, you know. So when I went back home, my roommate asked me, how was it? I said, that's a very good congregation here. Why are you walking this distance, going to this place to worship, you know? He said, what happened? I said, see what happened. They even welcomed me and everything, preach, you know, see what we were touched, be that my vision. I went to YouTube, played the music for him. He himself, he enjoyed it. You know, he had spent years before, like he had spent 4 years in Ukraine then, you know. But I think he knew most of you know him. Forgive me, I don't want to mention his name, you know. But he has left Ukraine as well. So it actually continued that when I was coming and then. God be the glory. Each message I hear, I always like leave a mark on me, and then, you know, I started noticing a very drastic change in my life, and that's how it has happened. Then, crossover night of December, you know, there was like a religious or a spiritual exercise, you know, that pastor said we should do, where you have to write down what you want God to do for you in the year 2015, you know. And that was the very first time I've actually done that in my life. I'm just a church goer, you know. I don't know what all those things mean, you know. But I said, okay, since this same pastor that has been preaching words that have actually impacted in my life, let me just try it, you know. And I wrote down so many things, and then of course I came to Ukraine as an unbeliever, you know. I know the kind of life I've lived back in Nigeria, you know. So. And I knew that for me to actually, yes, I believe then that I need to be saved. I need this salvation of faith, you know. So I wrote down so many things and for God to do for me in 2015, you know, like spiritual things and of course material things as well, you know, because you are in Europe, and you know, when you are in Europe, so many things, so much is expected. You cannot just fly for 5,000 feet above and come here, and you won't look like somebody that is in Europe. So I tell God, well, I came to Ukraine, no work, nothing, and all those things. So somehow it was kind of discouraging to me, you know. But when I started like knowing more about the scriptures and, you know, worshiping with this congregation, you know, like, my thinking about life and all those things had to change, you know. So back to the things I wrote, I told God, these are the things I want you to do for me, you know, starting from so many addictions, you know, because I know I was so entrenched in so many things that I know I'm not supposed to do as a real Christian, you know, because you have Christians, but you have real Christians, you know. But if you say you should worship God, you should worship Him in truth and in spirit and in truth, you know. I wrote down so many things, and we prayed over it and pertaining the land of Ukraine, because then there was war in Donetsk and all that. Even though my parents and friends, they were like, this Ukraine, you know, just like, yeah, they are killing, they are shooting there, you are still traveling to that place, you know. But then I was just like so desperate to leave Nigeria, you know, whole issues surrounding my life then, you know. But I was part of the prayer points I prayed, you know, peace in Ukraine, peace in Nigeria. Because then we were preparing for the 2015 election and some other things. And throughout that 2015, I was praying with it, you know, and then I started seeing changes in my life, and it was something that actually like made me feel that this salvation of the thing is actually possible. You know, it is not like an automatic thing, you know. And I came to understand so many things, you know, in the Bible, because each time I read the Bible and I pray, like mostly when I read the Bible, there's always a striking message. Like, since I never believed, imagine in my mind that I even in the Bible, you know. Like some people will always like tell you that this Jesus, they say he's coming, you know, but we have not seen him. Stop deceiving yourself, you know. And sometimes I came across a chapter of the Bible that said that 1,000 years is like a day in the eyes of God, a day or 5,000, I don't know. And I said, this can actually mean what's like when people are saying that there seems to be a whole lot of procrastination about Christ coming, you know. But then, after that, like, so I knew that there were some changes, you know. But in that 2015, there was something that was, like, very, very much important to me, you know. Like, I came here and they said that there is no work here. And then my roommate, before he left, he was telling me that summer 2015 in this country is always, like, something else, you know, that most people travel and all that. So, I started asking God, okay, that since there is no job, that maybe I have to maybe look for one of these countries and do everything. So I tried, it did not work, you know, I couldn't get a visa, you know, but I had to stay back. You know, and during that period, we did a whole lot of Bible teachings here. I think, what do you call it? I want to say thank you. You know, and we did a whole lot of teaching, and we were even given certificate of participation, you know. So it was that teaching was even a very big eye opener for me. Like within me, I felt that this might be the reason why maybe the embassy did not give me visa for the job for the country I wanted to apply to. You know, so I learned so many things, and I found out that all those addictions and so many things that I couldn't believe that I can actually live without doing, you know, that those things have become, you know, a thing of the past. And I'm so much excited about it. It's not just that things were actually well, you know, but I know that when you say that you actually believe in God and you are actually striving for this salvation, that you must be tempted, you know, you must be tested, rather, you know. And throughout all those years, you know, even till up to this time, you know, I've passed through a whole lot of tests, you know, and God be the glory of, like, I have been winning. You know, I've been winning. It's something I'm so happy about. And that was something happened during the last convention, which I just want to quickly share with us. You know. During the North Island convention, Easter New Year retreat. You know, we were having lunch. So one of our sisters, you know, she said, Brother Lotana, that since you believe in Ukraine very soon, I said yes, that I'll believe in. He said, okay, that's her. I will miss your black face. So, you know. So she said it. I don't know if she actually like had an ulterior motive to say it, you know. But me personally, I know that if I had replied that, maybe it will mean turning the house of God into a throwing the ground, you know, which I know is not good, because it doesn't make us understand that at least that you, the word that should come out from your mouth should be a healing word, you know. But no, the reason why I want to say that is that I think Isaiah 45:19, you know, Isaiah 45:9 said something about the potter and the clay, you know, that the clay should not tell the potter how it should be created, you know. So why am I saying this? Because most of, I think Pastor made something, made mention of that, something about that last Sunday he was preaching, you know, like, don't let people talk you down about how you look, you know, because she's a lady. If I had replied, I know she would have reported me to Pastor. And up till now, that word I will tell her will still be hurting her. I know. I know just one word, even if they call you Miss World, one word I will tell you. You look to me and all those things. I wonder if these people that call you Miss World, are you really Miss World? You know. So that's just one thing. We are Christians and we are believers as well. So we should feel proud, be proud of how God created us, and nobody should talk you down. Even tell me, even as a non-believer then, some of my friends, at times they feel they want to yell me, see this black man, say, you said I'm black. No, I'm charcoal in complexion. Yes. Because if you're actually proud of how you are, tomorrow nobody will yell you with you. See this short woman. No, I'm not short, I'm brief. Yes, tomorrow they won't say it again. You know. But praise God. I don't mean to evoke amusement, but I'm just trying to, like, you know, point out some things to this is a house of God, it's not a comedy house, because I know so many people actually feel bad about it. That, I think Sister Gloria, why during the inside the scripture, she made mention of it, that there are wars that can kill. You know, so you are a Christian, you are a believer, and an unbeliever is trying to stop you down. You should resist it. You know, some of us that watch football, there was one Barcelona player then, he was about playing corner, they threw a banana on him, he opened it and ate the banana. So that person that threw that banana on him, tomorrow that person will never try it again. Because even if you are calling him a monkey, he's proud to be a monkey, and there's nothing you can do about it, you know. So for me, it's been a great privilege being part of this congregation. Sorry if I'm taking your time, you know. And finally, to every beginning, there is an end. And today will be the last day I'll be worshiping with you guys.
Oh my God.
It's been a hard day for me and a hard time for me, because like before I came to Ukraine, and I didn't know any single soul here, you know. I don't know anybody. But I've met amazing sisters and brothers here, you know. Too many names, numerous to mention. You know, I'm not happy about that, but then when these things happen, there's nothing you can do about it. You just have to move on. You know, and there's some concerns, like maybe when I finish my bachelor's, there's this yearbook, you know, that we usually do, you know. And there was a time I just bought it out and I was just flipping through the pages, you know. See some people that they are gone, you know. Some love their life to one mysterious accident or illness or whatnot. You know, some got married, you know, got into the theater, they couldn't come out. Just one story and all, you know. And it's actually like made me feel bad, you know, because years back, these are people like, you know, when they have given you so much memories to actually hold on to and to remember, and the next thing it just becomes a reality to you that you can never see them again. You know, so what I'm trying to say is that we should all remain strong, you know, because times like this, when these things happen, there's nothing you can do about it. So praise God. So I want to say thank you and then I appreciate you.
Please.
There's no good in it. I've never seen any good in saying goodbye, you know. And another thing is that when you say goodbyes, you don't actually know which of the goodbyes is the last goodbye, because some of you don't know when next I see you. So thank you.